Welcome to the Microsoft's Azure Data Self-Help Series. My name is Kenny Yu, and today I'll be presenting on how to troubleshoot SQL Server Always-On Listener on Azure VM. There are many methods to deploy an availability group. When deploying an availability group in a single subnet and using a virtual network name, then a load balancer is needed. To avoid deploying a load balancer, use a distributed network name or use a multi-subnet deployment. Follow the online documentation to deploy a load balancer. A front-end IP address will be needed, and it is the IP address assigned to the cluster network resource. The IP address will reside on the same subnet as the VM and select this static assignment. After the front-end IP address has been added, next add the back-end pool, which will consist of each of the VM's IP addresses as shown here. Next, we will need to add a health pool, which will be using the TCP protocol and port 5999. The final step in configuring the load balancer is adding the load balancing rules. We will need to add the name, select IPv4, the front-end IP address, the back-end pool, the TCP protocol and port, the back-end port, which is 1433, and select the health probe that was added previously. This step is very important. We will need to run the following PowerShell script from the online documentation as shown here. The cluster network name can be found in the Failover Cluster Manager and then select Networks. To get the IP resource name, right-click the listener IP and select Properties and copy the name. The load balancer IP is the front-end IP address. The probe port is the health probe, which is 59999. A common error is a lack of permissions to create the cluster name objects when creating the cluster. Below is a list of permissions needed to create the cluster object name on Active Directory. Another common error is not adding the listener resource as the dependency of the AG resource in the cluster failover manager. The following ports will need to be open on the firewall and NSG rules. In this video, we covered how to configure a load balancer when using a VNN and common errors related to AG listeners. Thanks for watching. We hope this information in this video has been helpful to you.